This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're looking for evil guys.
Bigot rape and discrimination. The crime which are weakening America's ideas.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hey everybody, it's another Thursday, another episode of Openly Hostile Opinions, the internet's best comedy morning show.
Mm-hmm. What's up all you bros and hoes out there?
I'm Jay, this is my hetero life mate Casey.
Yes, what's up everyone? How's everyone doing today? I hope you're doing well and swell. Got like a little radio voice going on today.
Coming back on Easy 103, we have the Doobie Brothers.
Yeah. Oh man. I don't know, maybe it's allergies or something like that. Is your allergies acting up lately?
Yeah, I've been sneezing all morning.
Yeah, I had to take some allergy pills. Fucking, ugh, man. I've never had allergies until I moved out and bumfucked fucking Egypt. Jesus Christ, man.
Benadryl, because you can't sneeze when you're in a coma.
Yeah, it's my whole life I've never had allergies. I've always heard people complain about them, never had to deal with them. About 2 years ago when I moved out here, I'm like, no wonder people complain about them. They are fucking annoying. Holy shit. And a nose like this, I get nose headaches. Oh my God, it's ugh.
What the fuck is a nose headache? You know, big nose freak.
Like face headaches. When I get really bad allergies, my teeth hurt, my face hurts, and I just feel like my nose has a brain and it has a headache. Ugh.
I can't say I've ever had that same experience.
Yeah, it's fucking god awful. That's because your nose is normal size. Mine's the size of, you know, fucking the planet fucking Venus, or I don't fucking know. Yes, the size of a baby crying.
I'm surprised I didn't get a fuck you, Jay, on that.
Yeah, whatever. I'm not in a fuck you mood. I'm in a good mood. Watched a good movie last night. It was fucking hilarious. I laughed my ass off. Bad Santa 2, if you haven't seen it, go watch it. And it's World of Warcraft patch day. Woot woot!
Fuck does that mean?
It means that they released new content today, and I'm fucking excited.
Oh, new content. I was going to say, is it like the I'm going to fix the shit I broke?
No. That's everything. There's always something broke in the game, but whatever. It's patch day. I'm so excited. I can't wait. So after today, I'm probably going to play until I grow a beard.
That could take years.
Yeah, I know. I can't grow facial hair.
This little scruff you got going on here, how long did that take you? About 2 months?
Yeah, about a month probably. It's actually pretty good because I don't have to shave a lot, but like my stepdad, he says he shaves twice a day. Fuck that. Fuck that noise.
Or you can take my approach and just have a luxurious Viking beard.
Yeah, that's true. I could, but whatever.
No, you couldn't.
I was thinking about that the other day. I was thinking of a vagina for some reason.
Gee, I can't imagine why.
I think it's because of Bad Santa, too. He was telling this kid how to lose his virginity, and it was fucking hilarious. He's like, all right, now when she bends over, she's going to pull down her pants, and you're going to see something that looks like Asian food. It's not. It was hilarious. And I was just like, there's a lot of wrinkles and shit around that. That'd be annoying to shave. Like, thank God I don't have a vagina.
You've shaved your balls before. There's more wrinkles there.
Yeah, I know, but at least the balls, you can, like, pull them.
you know, stretch them out.
Yeah, you stretch them out a little bit like some chewing gum, and you can, like, but, like, the vagina.
That still kind of hurts to talk about.
Yeah, I know. I hate shaving. Oh, man. Fuck.
That's not what I'm talking about.
Oh, okay.
I kind of had a scalpel down there a few weeks ago.
Oh, yeah. Forgot about that. How's that going, by the way?
I didn't. it's fine. I mean, you know, still blowing loads all over the place.
House looks like you made clam chowder and missed, you know, stirred it too hard.
Still have to use condoms. I have to use condoms for either 4 months or 40 loads. I've got a freaking
40 loads. What is this, a Tide commercial?
I got a fucking tally mark sheet next to the bed.
Oh, I would too. I'd be edging them in the bedpost with like an old knife.
There ain't gonna be no 4 months for this guy. Oh, I promise you.
Oh,
I'm
man.
Working on it. I have doctor's orders. Clear that plumbing.
40 loads.
That's not what he said.
I know, but it's just funny. Like it reminds me of like an old Tide commercial where they're like, it now lasts up to 40 loads.
Yeah, they send you home with a little plastic cup, and then you gotta go to the lab. Like you just gotta come in all smiley face. Here's my big old sample of semen. Can y'all test my semen, please?
Oh, that's hilarious.
And I don't know where the lab is, too, so I'm going to have to go in and ask for directions. Can you point me to the lab? I got a bag of semen.
I'd go to the hottest nurse in there and be like, you know what to do. I'm like, don't, yeah.
See, I'm supposed to collect the sample myself and bring it in, but I don't have like 3 hours, so God forbid you get stuck in traffic or you know, an accident happens or some shit like that. I don't know why I decided to put a hat on today. I hate wearing hats.
Actually, you were wearing the hat that every Marvel comic book character wears in a movie to look to blend in. Did you ever notice that? They always wear a blank hat.
I need
hat
a hood
like
over it, though. You know, here's something stupid. You know that they're calling basic ball caps now dad hats, and they're trendy now?
Like, of course they are, because the internet is fucking retarded.
Yeah, so now you got to go to a store and spend $35 on a regular baseball cap because now it's a fashion trend called dad cap.
Oh, my God. Like, are we done yet? Jesus nope. Christ, people. Like,
if you fuck, all right, look out there, you. If you fuckers are going to appropriate fashion, stop appropriating shit I wear.
I know.
I'm tired of shit getting expensive.
I know, like, I.
But if you're looking for something badass to wear, get online and buy one of our lovely Openly Hostile Opinions t-shirts. Yours in any size available for as little as $20.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, I look at a lot of Instagram and shit like that. And there's all these fucking teeny boppers and shit like that. Like, 18 to 20. I don't know how fucking old they are. But they're like, they're so amazed at some of the fashion things that they found that existed long time ago.
Yeah. And they say shit goes on like a 30-year loop.
Yeah, but like, it's like this one girl was like showing that she had jelly shoes on or something. I'm like, bitch, that was fucking years ago. You're a little late. And the thing is they think they're so cool. God, man. I never thought.
You sound like such a fuddy-duddy right now.
It's just weird to me. Like, there's a huge thing on Instagram right now, and it's how much people like pizza. And I don't get why it's cool yet or anything, but they made, like, pizza swimsuits now. And it's, like, it's always a really attractive girl, too.
Apparently pizza's taken over for bacon, I guess.
Yeah, I know. And it's always, like, a really attractive girl in, like, a pizza. Or she has, like, pieces of pizza covering her nipples or something. She's like, I eat pizza every day. And, like, with a body like that, yeah, you do, bitch. Sit the fuck down. You're gonna learn today.
you know, everybody these days are doing weird shit, and because of the fucking internet, you know, things spread so fast anymore.
I know. Holy
like,
fuck.
The
man.
Latest dumbassery becomes, you know, news in a day.
Yeah.
You know, what do you think people used to fucking do before they had the internet?
I don't fucking know. We actually, I have something fun later after the beer of the week.
Okay, well, let's do the beer of the week, and we'll go back because you ruined my segue.
We'll go back to that because I actually, that's a thing today, is we're going to start talking about things that, if you're younger and you watch the show, you won't really understand them, and it might seem weird to you, but if you're older and you, it's going to be a nice throwback. It's going to be a nice throwback.
fucking up my segue. That was seamless.
I know.
Seamless. All right.
So, this week, we're going to try something from Lagunitas. Now,
Lagunitas! Yay!
Maracas!
No, we don't stereotype.
Yeah, no, not at all.
Okay, you know what? Fuck this hat. Hang on. There you go. My hat can be in the shot. Oh, no. Fuck.
Nope. Your hat's like, fuck you, I'm out. 40 loads.
My hat will co-star today.
Yeah. It's like, I ain't dealing with these 40 loads, I'm out. And, I picked this because I have a lot of friends that actually drink it. If anyone remembers when Kevin was in the show, he actually brought his own beer, and it was from Lagunitas. It was called the Maximus, but we are not going to try the Maximus today. We're going to try the Lagunitas Little Something Something Wild Ale. And I've never had this before, but like I said, I know a lot of friends that drink this. So,
it's all right.
Yeah, I think it's from California, actually.
Lagunitas!
Yeah, Lagunitas! A Spanish beer from California, that's weird.
Yeah, it's from Petaluma. Yeah. Petaluma, which used to house the new screensavers. A little shout out to the Twit Network there. Leo Laporte, we love you. Please put us on your show someday.
And, yeah, and they also have a company in, or a factory, I should say. I don't know what to call it, in Chicago, Illinois. So, yeah, let's go ahead and try this. Ding dong, motherfucker.
Ding dong.
Ooh, very hoppy. Very, very hoppy. And
yeah,
actually,
I've had way hoppier than that.
Yeah. Actually, I get a lot of grapefruit. Do you get a lot of grapefruit?
I'm getting a little grapefruit.
Actually, to tell the truth, to me, it's like drinking grapefruit juice, as in a little bit.
It does. It's very tart.
Yeah.
It is tart.
You know what? This would be actually really good as a hangover beer, I think. Like, you know how people drink mimosas or whatever the fuck they're called?
Mimosas?
Mimosas.
Or if you're a redneck, you have a redneck mimosa, which is beer and tang.
Beer and tang. That's so great. We got to try. We're going to do that next week. Beer and tang.
Yeah, fuck the fuck the regular beer of the week. We're going to do, you know, Budweiser and tang.
Yeah, like a Bloody Mary or something. Try one of these. Like, I could see drinking this during breakfast or something, to tell you the truth. It is very citrusy.
Well, if you're an alcoholic, you always drink beer for breakfast.
Yeah, that's true. actually, alcoholics, you know, only go to meetings. So
if you remember my stepfather, Big Ron, who was on here a couple weeks ago, he was on Vegas, a little over the weekend vacation recently, and sent me a picture of his breakfast, and it was, you know, eggs and a beer.
Yeah, I did see that. I think he posted on Facebook, didn't he?
I don't know. I don't use Facebook.
No, that's right. You're smart. Because Facebook...
Oh, I have my own time sucks.
Yeah. And, yeah, so do you like this beer?
Yeah, it's not my favorite, but it's good.
Yeah. I actually really... Like, I thought it was going to be... Like, I never had this before. I thought it was going to be something completely different. I thought it was going to be a little hoppy, but not as... and see, that's the thing. I can't really tell if it's hoppy or it's just a lot of citrus in it.
You know what it is? It's a one-trick pony. That's why I don't like it as much as some of the other ones. We've had some very complex, interesting things in here. And this one's, like I said, it's a one-trick pony. It's hoppy, and that's all it's got going on for it.
Yeah, there's not much. Like, I know a lot of beers we have, like, it starts out as something ends as something else. This is just straight, like, you're getting fucked by a grapefruit.
Not as much as that smash bomb, though. That shit was really strong.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Yeah, I was got groceries the other day, and I found some of that insanity in my fridge. I was like, oh, God. Do you remember that?
I had to buy it by a four-pack.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus.
You know a beer is expensive when it only comes a four-pack.
Yeah, I know.
Still costs like $12.
Yeah, if I would have to rate this... It's pretty good. I've definitely had better, but I'm going to give it 3.5 green cards out of 5.
I'll go 3.
3?
Three. Yeah. 3 for me. I'm not excited by it. It's okay.
Yeah, it's okay.
It's okay.
And like
it's...
I said, I've known a lot of people, a lot of friends that drink. Oh, Jesus Christ.
This is a classy show.
Yeah. We're going to get cough drops one of these times so we can mute this stuff out, but I know I'll just forget because... You know, I
have all the stuff to make them. I'm just lazy, and we need to buy more cables. And
yeah,
it's easier for me to just go.
Yeah, exactly.
Turn my head and fucking be done with it.
We actually have a lot of stuff planned. It's just me and Jay are lazy, and we just keep forgetting.
And we're poor.
Yes, we're very poor. And that reminds me, you can donate on Patreon.
Yeah, go to patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. If you pledge as little as a dollar, that would help.
Yeah,
significantly.
Yes, we're poor. Give us money. Like that Fry meme, shut up and give us money.
Shut up and take my money. Well, shut up and give me yours.
Yeah, exactly. So moving right along, like we were saying, I have a little something we want to talk about today, just about things that were a little different before technology. Not just the internet, but just technology in itself, smartphones, everything like that.
Oh, so you're talking about in the dark ages in the 90s when we grew
yeah,
up.
Yeah, basically.
The 80s and 90s.
The 80s, 90s and stuff like that. And it just reminds me, there's this new show on Fox and they time travel in it. They went back to the 90s. I'm like, ugh, I'm old.
Yeah, there's another one that I'm watching that I like watching. Frequency is the same thing. They cut it. She's talking to her deceased dad through a ham radio back in the way back 90s.
Oh, God, yeah, it made me feel old. Like, he went back and they were at an arcade and this kid was playing NBA Jam. Oh, that game.
Everybody's got flip phones.
Yeah, did you ever used to play NBA Jam?
I was never a big basketball fan. I mean, I played it.
So much fun, man. He's on fire. Like, if you did really good, you got on fire, and you just run really fast, and you'd shoot the ball, and if the ball was on fire, it'd catch the net and burn the net. It was just a really fucking fun game. But anyways, moving right along. I just have a list here. We'll probably bring up some other things like that. But the first one I have here is people... Back before cell phones and everything like that, there was a lot of pay phones around. You don't see much of those dinosaurs anywhere. But they used to have this thing called collect calling. And when you
they still do.
Yeah.
Ask the prisoners.
Yeah, exactly. But you don't really use it anymore. But there was a way to get around it. And what would happen is say I would be like, hey, mom, I'm going here. When I need a ride, I'll call you. And you used to call a collect call and you used to be like, please say your name at the tone so they knew who was calling you. And then he'd be like, do you want to accept the charges? Well, when you would say your name, all you would say is, hey, mom, it's Casey. Come and pick me up.
What's your name? Hey, mom, need a ride.
Yeah. And they would be like, I do not accept the charges. And they'd hang up the phone and they'd come and get you. And there was actually a commercial. I don't know if you remember this, but there was a commercial way back in the day making fun of this. Mm-hmm. And it's when these parents had a baby and they were calling people and were like, had a baby, it's a boy.
Yep, I remember that. There was even T-shirts and shit. If it was today, it would have a hashtag.
Yeah, exactly.
Hashtag. Had a baby, Issa boy.
And then that was pretty funny. Actually, I can't tell you. I don't remember what the commercial was actually for, but I still remember that commercial. I thought it was pretty funny.
Speaking of commercials, you remember the Noid?
Yeah.
I miss the Noid
the
commercials.
The Domino's.
Yeah, it'd come and ruin your pizza.
Yeah. I wonder what happened to him.
Well, I most marketing things, it goes out like the Taco Bell Chihuahua. You get a Taco Bell.
Yeah, if you don't know what that is, look that up. It's the Taco Bell used to have this little Chihuahua, and he used to say, Lagito Taco Bell.
Lagito.
Whatever.
Lagito Taco Bell with our Lagunitas.
Yeah, we're very Mexican. My sombrero back there, I should probably put it on.
Yo quito Lagunitas. Yeah, that means exactly. I want some. I want some Taco Bell. Some Lagunitas.
Yeah, so that was always interesting. I thought that was pretty funny trying that. Hey, people find a way around the system. people use pagers.
Yeah, I had a pager.
Did you really? No, yeah. I did not. Because my family, if you had a pager, you were a drug dealer. And it is true. A lot of people used pagers that were drug dealers. And basically, it sort of made no sense if you think about it, but it did back then. Because you weren't always home and you didn't have cell phones. They were out around now, but they weren't that popular. And for younger people that don't know what a pager is, it's this little block. It's basically, it looks like a little small, it's about the size of a deck of cards maybe. And they would call your pager and you would look at it and it would show a number and then you go to the nearest phone and call them back. Do you remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I never had a pager. Never did. But, I remember my stepbrother wanted one for Christmas, and they got him a fake one with gum in it, because only drug dealers had pagers.
Fucking with me, because I'm a teenager with a little bit of dough in a pager.
And that's the thing, like...
NWA style.
Yeah, back in the day, they had a lot of rap songs talked about pagers, because having a pager was, like, the shit.
Fuck the police.
Yeah.
Fuck. Okay, sorry. having a moment.
Back in the day, you used to have to wait to get pictures developed. Like, you think about this now, and it's very strange to me. You take a picture with a phone, and you just have the picture. You had to go to these small, like, little shops and shit and get your film developed. And when you got it developed, half your pictures didn't even turn out.
Yeah.
Like... And then, like, you'd have to pay extra for doubles and all this shit, and it was just, I don't know. It was fucking weird.
It was.
You would get these little disposable cameras you'd buy for a couple dollars, and you'd take them, and they would, what would it take, like a week, maybe?
Something like that.
Yeah, it would take a week to get your...
Well, some places are like one-hour photos.
Oh, I remember that, yeah.
And, you know, you, like all the teenagers taking naked pictures of their girlfriends and shit. They'd keep them.
Yeah.
They wouldn't give them...
Yeah, back. And a lot of people, I, no one really took selfies back in the day. Like, I don't, like, do you ever remember taking a disposable camera and taking a picture of yourself?
No, but I don't do that now.
I know, but, like, did you ever, I don't remember ever seeing people do that. How did like, evolve with the cell phone, I guess? I guess just boredom.
Instagram. I blame Instagram.
I blame Instagram. Here's another thing. I remember when I was younger, I used to have, you would never leave the house if you were waiting for a phone call. Do you remember, like, revolving your whole day around a phone call?
I remember actually getting phone calls nowadays. Everybody just texts you. If you call me, I'm insulted by that. Like, what?
Yeah, I know.
I need to drop what I'm doing to respond to your ass?
Mm-hmm.
Leave me a text. I'll do it at my convenience when I'm taking a shit, like civilized people.
I know a lot of people like that. You'll And it's even to the point where you text them and they'd be like, why you texting me? That wasn't even important.
Well, my wife's like, she'll call me constantly, always calls, never texts.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, everybody else, just text me. I can't, you know, it's my wife though. What am I going to do? Tell her stop fucking calling me.
Mm-hmm.
She does that. She's liable to move her shit out while I'm not there someday. No, I don't want that.
Yeah. Still got to blow loads in her. Up to 40 loads.
Well, I didn't get a vasectomy to not have sex, so there's that.
Next thing, this is, I remember this being so cool back in the day, but now that you think of it today, it is very, it would be very annoying. You didn't know what was on TV. So basically, you subscribe to these little magazines, and I remember my mom got it for my stepdad every year at Christmas. It was a yearly subscription to TV Guide.
Well, as long as I can remember, there was a TV Guide channel.
Yes, but this was before that.
Scroll through. I've always had that from the time I was a little kid.
Yeah. See, I don't remember always having the TV Guide channel, and that's another thing. Actually, there was this channel, and I think it was like channel 10 or something like that. You would sit there and wait for your channel to scroll to see if something was on.
Yeah.
And it was called the TV Guide channel, but they also, once a week or once a month, I think, they sent you this magazine, and you had to look through it to see what was on TV.
Or they published it in newspapers.
Yeah.
I don't know if they still do or not.
No.
I don't know. I haven't. Hey, there's one. When you used to read a newspaper when you wanted information.
And there's a lot of great articles about this stuff, because it was also talking about people today get information all throughout the day.
And porno.
Yeah. Before that, you got information basically once a day. Either it was the newspaper, you watched the nightly news or something like that. You got information like once a day. Now it's just like, it's every fucking day.
Oh, it's constant. You know, 5 minutes at work at a break, I can look and see what's happening in the world today.
Yeah, exactly.
It allows idiots with a couple $100 and time on their hands to do a podcast.
I know. Who does that? Jesus fucking Christ.
Well, here's one I want to bring up. Porn.
Yeah, I know.
I
yeah.
remember I used to be fucking masturbating at JCPenney cataloging this shit. You'd have to go dumpster diving in the recycler bin down at the park to try and see if somebody threw away some pornos.
Yeah, like
every once in a while you'd score.
Yeah, no, exactly. Like there was no fapping material. Like it was like the holy grail if you found fapping material.
I know you were usually settling for that JCPenney catalog, and if you actually found some porn, it didn't matter what it was.
Yeah,
I remember one time dumpster diving, I found an over 40. They were naked.
Yeah, you'd be like, ooh, she's showing ankle.
She took her pants off, and it looked like Fidel Castro's beard, but
hey,
it was a puss.
I know, and that's the thing. Like, you either had to steal movies, like, from people, or steal magazines, or go dumpster diving, hopefully you found porn.
Or if you were lucky, your dad was a pervert and had him, like, in the under the bed or in his closet. We all had that one friend whose dad was a pervert.
Yeah, yeah. We still do.
trade tapes. You'd be like going to like a drug dealer, reeing up.
Yeah, it was sort of like Pogs back in the day. What you got?
had a fucking re-up trade the midget porn tape for the tranny porn tape.
Yeah, and be like, hey, two midget porn tapes count as one because they're half the size. another one is before caller ID. You had no idea who the fuck called you. So you had to star 69 people, and it would call the last person that called you. And it would cost 50 cents. And if you did this, your parents got fucking pissed. Who in the fuck star 69? Because 50 cents.
God forbid.
Yeah, I know. Do you ever get yelled at for star 69?
I don't think I ever did.
Oh, man.
I never star 69. I would screen my phone calls with our answering machine.
Oh, man, that was so bad. I used to get bitched at so much.
I still won't answer a phone call if I don't know who it is.
I know, me either. Fuck it. I don't care. Whatever.
You don't answer a phone call when you do know who it is.
That's because I'm never around my phone. Like, I'm hardly... And my phone, I don't know. When I moved out here, my phone dies really quick, so it's always on the charger.
It's probably looking for signal a lot.
Yeah, and I always have my headset on because I'm usually playing a computer game or something or listening to music, so I just don't hear my phone go off. And then like 2 hours later, I'm like, oh, I'll reply.
Yeah, it's funny. You know, one of my favorite pet peeves with cell phones is when somebody calls you and then you miss the phone call because you're doing something and to wash your hands, whatever. And then you call them immediately back and they don't answer. Like, what do they do? Drop the phone and run as far away as they can.
I know. They're like, fuck this, I'm out.
It's like, he didn't answer. Throw it out the fucking window.
Yeah. Oh, man, it's fucking weird. And the last one we have here, people use phone books. And I know phone books aren't that weird to think about, but when you think about using a phone book before phones, if the phone book wasn't updated or you didn't get the newest phone book and people moved, you're fucked. Like, I like, if you had a phone number and it was, and plus you can unlist too. There was people, they used to pay, I think you had to pay for it, didn't you, to unlist your name in the phone book?
It was like $2.
Yeah. Like, if you couldn't find it, you were fucked, dude. Like, you had no. And there was another thing when I was looking, is people don't memorize phone numbers anymore.
Oh,
and
no, I don't even know my own half the time.
I know, I don't either. I think I've had this phone for, I don't know, fucking 3-4 years, and I think I just started learning it.
You still haven't set up your damn voicemail yet.
No, I think I have, or maybe I didn't.
No,
I don't
you
know.
Didn't. I tried leaving it a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, I just don't give a fuck. Whatever.
When I want to leave, when I want to talk to him, I'll just text him. Yeah. He'll call back eventually.
Yeah, eventually, whatever. When Azeroth is done, needs saving. I can't wait. It's patch day. So excited.
You need a woman.
No, I don't. Women are horrible. I'm going to get me started on those freaks.
No, it's not self-imposed or anything. It's not your own fault.
No, I just can't fucking help it. Women are disgusting.
I know quite a few would say the same about you, Case.
That's all right. They let me inside of them.
Probably not willingly.
Not willingly. Yeah, you had a caveman.
Fucking like Dexter creeping in the shadows and shit.
I heard they're actually making a... They're going to start recording that again when he's a lumberjack in Canada, I guess, or something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that reminds me, have you watched Logan yet?
No.
No, you haven't.
No, I haven't been able to get to a theater. Yeah.
I like how you say that, like a theater's like something valuable. Like,
well,
no, I haven't been able to get to the hospital.
I have two kids, and I'm cheap. So put those two things together. I don't make it to a movie theater often. Unless I'm super excited to see something. In addition to that, my car is busted.
That he was supposed to fix today, but it is fucking shit out today.
Yeah, it's raining and
I wish this fucking weather would make up its fucking mind. It's like, what, like just 2 weeks ago, we had, what, 20 inches of snow?
Something like that,
yeah. We had 20 fucking inches of snow, and now it's raining and shit. I heard toads and frogs out last night and birds flying around and shit.
Yeah, it's like 95 in our studio today because your heat's still on.
Yeah, I got
like
a
55
new,
outside.
Yeah, I got a new thermostat I installed, and it fucking works a little too good.
Yeah, if we're looking a little red, there's a reason for it.
It is fucking hot in here. Like last week, you said you were really warm, and I was fine, but now I'm like, ugh. I think it's this beer, actually, because it's like 8% alcohol.
No, there's that, too.
Yeah, and the last couple of beers we had, what, it was like 4%, something like that. Very low.
Yeah, not everything has to be a big beer to be good.
Yeah, exactly. And I think, like, the last month we had beer that was, like, under 4% or 5%, something like that.
Yeah, probably.
So I think this is making me a little warm.
All right, so I got a good one for us.
What's that?
For those of you out there who may not be familiar, there's a guy out there. He's a metal musician by the name of Danzig.
Yeah.
Yeah. Had a big hit back in the 90s with Mother. made an appearance on Aqua Teen Hunger Force in Portlandia. Anyway, so Glenn Danzig is just, he's like cartoony. He's so over the top. You know, it's all tongue-in-cheek, shticky. He's the demon. Okay.
He makes
Gene Simmons look like, you know, a normal dude down the street. And he's occasionally had a metal fest over the years called The Blackest of the Black. But now it's going to be getting a, like a permanent home, I guess, at Oak Canyon Park in Orange County, California later this year. And it's being built as a destination festival, whatever the fuck that means. It's going to feature, get this, if you know anything about Danzig, this is the most Danzig thing ever. It's going to feature a castle, a bondage stage, a sacrifice altar, and a bloodbath.
No, because the reason why this is funny is because Aqua Teen Hunger Force made fun of this shit.
Well, like, it's not the only reason.
How many years ago did they come out with that episode? And they did it because it's so true.
Can you make the blood run up the walls?
Like, he buys Carl's house and he tries...
After it's been possessed.
Yeah, after it's been possessed. and there's blood running down the walls, and he wants to pay Carl more to make it run up the walls. So when you hear this, it's so funny to me because Aqua Teen nailed it years ago about dancing.
Yeah, and it's got the cybernetic ghost of Christmas past in it. Have you guys seen my robot? That motherfucking robot was supposed to come with the motherfucking house.
He gets so pissed, and then the robot's like hiding because Danzig scares him because he's like, I don't like him, and he doesn't wear a shirt.
He's so terrifying. He's so annoying, and he never wears a shirt.
It is so fucking funny. No, it's just, keep going. I'm sorry. That's just, Aqua Teen nailed that.
I mean, Danzig is so ridiculous. I love the man's music, but he's just such a cartoon character. You know, the Misfits reunited this year and for those Riot Fests, and sadly I wasn't able to go, although our buddy Joe did, that motherfucker.
Joe?
Well, he lives right there in Chicago.
Oh, that's right. Yeah,
that's where he's stationed. So.
Chicago!
But anyway, I'm kind of glad I didn't get to see it because I saw pictures of the show, and Glenn's wearing this like ridiculous like leather shirt with a harness on it, and he's, you know, he's 61 and he's fat.
He was showing me pictures and it's fucking hilarious.
Oh, and you know, he's got this big gut, you know, but he's, like I said, he's fucking 61, you know.
Yeah.
I'm not making fun of the man for aging. If I look as good as he does at 61, I would congratulate myself.
Yeah.
But when you're 61, you have to have a little bit of a
modesty.
Awareness.
Awareness.
An awareness of what your body looks like. Like, maybe not choose mesh.
you said dad hats are in, so, you know, there was actually an article that dad bodies are in.
Well,
women like
he's got
beer
one.
Guts today, I guess, is a huge thing.
Well, fuck, I'm sexy.
It's fucking weird.
So anyway, if you're interested in going to this, apparently Danzig, of course, is going to headline the festival. The lineup will also include Suicidal Tendencies, Badass, Corrosion of Conformity, Ministry, Suicide
Ministry.
Silence.
Yeah.
Discharge. Discharge. I don't know Discharge.
Corrosion of Conformity still playing. Wow, I seen them a long time ago. They opened up for Metallica.
Yeah, Pepper Keenan's playing with them again, so that's good. Atreyu.
They're still around?
More. Ugh. Evidently.
Atreyu's, they used to be so good. Then they just fucking...
They were never good.
Oh, their one album was really good, their first one, and then they just went to the shithole.
They've also got a couple of... Oh, Devil Driver's playing.
Wow.
Belphegor, Butcher Babies, Cumbie Christ. Actually, there's some pretty good shit on... Oh, and Full Metal Jackie's hosting it. Yo, shout out. Full Metal Jackie's awesome.
Oh, damn.
I can't believe Ministry's playing, though.
I can't believe there's a fucking bloodbath.
Sacrifice Altars, man.
Like, there has to be pictures of this. Did it start yet?
No. Buy tickets. They're on sale now.
And I can't believe it's in California. Is he from California?
He lives there now. He's from Lodi, New Jersey.
I asked you a question. I thought you were going to go, yeah.
Yeah! Come on. How much are the tickets?
Probably
$3,000.
They're like $3,000 plus an extra $50 for the bloodbath.
Alternate pricing may be available. I want to know.
Like, is it? Yeah, but the thing is like, you're not gonna go all the way to California, are you?
Maybe. Maybe I can convince my wife to let me go.
Oh man, California is awesome.
There ain't no way I'm gonna be able to go to California.
I love the weather there. I seen one cloud there the whole fucking week I was there. It never rains, and when it does, people get pissed. Like, it's fucking raining. It's like, how's it fucking feel? Jesus.
Oh, I would love to like live in a place like that where it's constantly nice.
Yeah. Oh man. It is. It's constantly, like, I always heard stories about California. It's always nice. It fucking is. It's like always around 70, 80 degrees. There's like one cloud in the sky that appears once a week and it never rains. There was a little wind there when I was there, and I don't know. And when I was there, people said it was actually pretty cold for California weather, but
still hot.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, listen to this. Blackest of the Black Festival is the brainchild of Glenn Danzig. The event not only serves as a music festival, but as a cultural experience, an escape. Coming to Oak Canyon Park in Silverado, California, in Orange County on Memorial Day weekend, Friday, May 26th, and Saturday, May 27th, Blackest of the Black will host two music stages curated by Danzig, with performances by some of the heaviest acts around, including Danzig Ministry, Suicidal Tendencies, Atreyu, Vamps, and many more. The festival will also feature camping and a number of sinister attractions, including Castle Danzig, a fully immersive walkthrough experience of pain, pleasure, and metal based upon the music and graphic novels of Glenn Danzig.
This is a horrible idea.
This is
a,
are you fucking kidding me?
Dude,
they're going to have a freak show. They're going to have a suspension stage where people...
Where they put
hooks in themselves.
Yeah. Okay, this can't go wrong.
Sacrifice Altar. Castle Danzig runs on virgin blood. Every hour, Dracuja will perform the task on our beautiful sacrifice altar.
Oh,
you'll
my
be provided
God.
With a white cloak as the ritual music comes in and the lights go down. Don't look at the knife above you. Sorry, fellas, ladies only. This is a bloody one. You may have to sacrifice your clothes as well.
Because it is ladies' night, or what?
The bondage stage. Exercise restraint with a few yards of rope and a sawhorse. Our Shinberry Knotmaster will provide you with an uncomfortable position you won't be able to wriggle out of.
Oh, my God. So they're actually doing it to you.
Oh, yeah. Padded cell. Oh. Going crazy? Well, then slip into a straitjacket and chill out in the padded cell. Your friends can watch you lose your mind on CCTV.
Every day for me.
Yeah.
Why do you have to pay to do that? That's every day for me.
You get to experience being locked down, escaped if you can't. Oh, electro stage.
You get electrocuted?
Have you ever been completely...
Yeah, this is going to work out fine.
Have you been completely desensitized, living a life of metal and horror movies? We'll shock you all right with 10,000 volts of lightning as you're strapped to a torture cross. We're sure it's fun.
See, if I was this, I would have been like, I would have dressed up like a Pokemon trainer and be like, oh, Pikachu, I choose you. People are like, what the fuck is this retard doing?
Drakija Bloodbath. Witness one of Danzig's most iconic characters come to life in the Drakija Slave Theater. She will guide you through her castle of terrors. Be prepared to be baptized by her virgin offerings.
Oh, my God.
You get to stick your head in stocks and get photos.
Hey, if the virgin's there, I'll pay for that.
It's sad when sticking your head through the stocks and taking a picture is like literally the most tame thing here.
I know, that's ridiculous.
They have a traveling troupe of freaks for a freak show, an oversized Ouija board game. It looks like somebody's dining room table that somebody painted. There's going to be thrill rides. Paint your face like a sugar skull. Yet again, that's the most tame thing there is the thrill rides. Okay, so the VIP pack. Okay, now we got some prices. The VIP package with the Blackest of the Blacks VIP lounge is $129.
That's
actually
it?
Not bad.
That's not bad at all, dude.
It's one VIP admission ticket a Friday, access to the VIP entrance lane, commemorative laminate, access to VIP viewing area near the main stage.
That's not bad
VIP
at all.
VIP lounge.
That's really not bad at all. I thought it was going to be like $500, $600.
You get a meet and greet for $199. Even that's not terrible.
I'm not a big damn
fan. And a private restroom. That right there.
You get a private restroom?
VIP cash bar, exclusive food.
What if like 5,000 people buy this?
I don't know.
Like they have that many bathrooms?
Oh,
I wonder why California's short on water. Like, what the fuck? Dude, Danzig, you are the weirdest motherfucker, like, ever.
I can't lie. This sounds like the most fun thing ever.
I don't even really like Danzig. I enjoy some of his stuff, but I wouldn't say I'm a fan like you are. I want to go.
Oh,
just
listen to
see. Like, dude, I'm just, like, I just would get a blanket, lay it down with a 12-pack of beer, and just watch all day. Like, I don't even want to take, this is just too great.
Here's the ultimate package, Saturday only. Not of this world. Ultimate VIP package. $399 plus fees. One VIP admission ticket the Saturday for Blackest of the Black. Access to VIP entrance lane, commemorative laminate, access to VIP viewing area, priority lane access to Castle Danzig. Access to VIP lounge, which includes comfortable areas to sit down and relax, private restrooms, VIP cash bar, and exclusive food. Exclusive meet and greet with Glenn Danzig. Now, the other one doesn't get you to meet Glenn, apparently. It gets you the other performers.
Glenn!
A Blackest of the Black poster and a merchandise voucher, good for one Blackest of the Black festival t-shirt.
This is so ridiculous.
I want to go. I am so sad I can't go to this.
Dude, I am so curious. Because I know that so much bad shit's going
to
happen.
You're going to shit yourself right now.
What?
This fucking shit is all ages. What? What?
Are you fucking kidding me?
There's like fucking sacrifices and shit, and it's all ages.
Oh my God.
This should at least have an 18 or over sticker.
There is going to be so many diseases being spread at this thing. Like,
I want to go. This sounds like the coolest thing ever.
Half the country is going to get AIDS from this thing. Like, nothing could go wrong.
It's like the Carnival of Satan here.
Oh my God. That is so fucking ridiculous.
Oh my God, who would have thought one little advertisement could make a whole half hour story, but fucking
money.
I gotta admit though, he's going above and beyond just your regular festival, but holy shit, what the fuck are you doing?
Dude, we should start a fucking Kickstarter and see if we can get enough people to contribute. So we'll live podcast from the blackest of the black.
Dude, just to see some of this shit, like I'm just picturing this bloodbath. Like, I'm just picturing like this old Roman area with like where they had like old Roman baths, but it's just filled with blood. And there's like, you know, little Timmy over there just got out of preschool and he's getting electrocuted by some virgin. And it's just, oh man. And it, oh, this is just so funny.
Oh my God. I can't. Dude, everybody right now sign up to Patreon, and if we get enough people, we will go buy tickets to this shit. We will fly to California, and we will fucking we'll record as much as we're allowed to.
Oh man, I don't know. Danzig, you're fucking weird. Oh, Jesus Christ. Burping up that grapefruit. Ugh. Danzig, you're fucking weird, dude. Like, I'm sorry. You're just, I never thought, like, I don't know. I just, whatever. Just whatever, dude. Whatever you want to do, go ahead with all 4 foot of you. Whatever. I don't know. That's just fucking weird.
At first, I was making fun of the thing because I just read the headlines and yeah. I brought up the website and like, my God, this is more than I could ever imagine.
So that actually sounds fun to you?
Oh, my God, yeah.
Dude, I would just go to see what people were doing.
Oh,
like,
man.
Just to see how people are reacting to this bloodbath, this fucking electrocution shit and stuff like that. Because people do that, like, I don't know. People, like, when they want to be tortured and stuff, they, you know, go away in their little dungeons and do it. They don't do it in public.
There'll be a lot of erections.
Yeah, exactly. That's me. I'd put a cucumber in my pants and just walk around.
fucking Spinal Tap style.
Yeah, exactly.
I just watched that the other day again. God, Spinal Tap is such a funny movie.
Oh, yeah, it's so fucking great. It's such a rock and roll.
Rock and roll!
Such a great fucking movie. I love that movie.
My favorite part of the whole thing is when... When the bass player Derek Stamalis gets stuck in that pot. He's in there playing, trying to get out. Yeah. They're banging on it with hammers and shit.
And right when the song ends, he finally gets out, and then it closes, and he's trying to get back in it because they go back in it. That's such a great fucking movie.
Or Stonehenge.
Yeah, I love all, like, fucking parody movies like that. They don't make them like they used to. The scary movies used to be good, but... It's like the last, not another teen movie was good too. If you haven't seen that, I'd suggest watching that. That is fucking hilarious. Not another teen movie was probably like the last good parody movie. Because I love like Robin Hood Men Tight, Spaceballs, Blazing Saddles.
Yeah. Anything Mel Brooks did. Is
yeah,
good.
Such great fuck movie. Naked Guns are some of my favorite movies. And one
Hot
of my,
Shots.
Yeah, Hot Shots. There's actually one when Val Kilmer, he was like 14 in it. And it's called Top Secret. And it is so fucking funny.
I've never seen that.
Oh, you gotta watch it, dude. It's great. Like, he meets this French guy, and he's like, hey, this is Deja Vu. And he's like, hello, have we met before? It's just fucking hilarious. It's so great.
What's it called?
Top Secret.
Top Secret.
And it's, and dude, fucking Val Kilmer's like 12 in it or something. He's so young. It's so great.
So it was before he got fat.
Yeah, exactly.
In 1984, he wasn't that young.
Oh, he was young. He was really young. He looks so fucking young in it. And one of my favorite scenes of this is they're sitting at this dinner table, and he's in Germany, and he's talking to this girl, and he goes, like, she speaks German.
Mm-hmm.
And she's talking to him in German, and he goes, oh, I know a little German. And he points to this guy, and it's a little midget. And he's like, hello. He's like, say I know a little German. It's just stupid comedy, but it's fucking hilarious. It is so good. I would watch it sometime. It's just hilarious.
That's funny.
How old's Val Kilmer now?
57.
57.
So.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know.
I suck at math.
Okay. I could sit here and figure it out and calculate, but fuck that shit.
Yeah. He was really fucking young in it. And actually, I'd never heard of the movie, but there was a sale. Shit. FYE. What did FYE used to be called?
For Your Entertainment.
No, what it used to be called before that. Wasn't it something called before that at the mall? Shit. What was that called?
I don't know. Did we used to have a Tower Records or something?
No, it was something like that.
I don't know.
It was a Naked Gun and Airplane combo box set, and that came with it for free.
Oh, yeah?
And I never heard of it. I watched it, and it was fucking hilarious. It's amazing.
It's got a pretty shitty rating.
Oh, yeah, of course, because no one likes parody movies anymore. What was the rating on it?
The IMDb has it 7.2.
Oh, that's pretty high.
Yeah, that's not bad. I was looking at the popularity, and it took a nosedive recently, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, so.
Probably because it has Nazis in it.
Yeah, whatever.
Oh, there's an ad for the Beauty and the Beast movie. I heard that's pretty fucking good.
Yeah, you know, it features bestiality in it, but everybody's all mad about the fact that it's got a, you know, fucking gay character. I love that. People are like fucking talking about, you know, this is our first gay character in Disney and blah, blah, blah. Like Smee and Captain Hook.
Yeah, I know. And in the original Beauty and the Beast, that guy was gay as fuck. Like, this isn't new.
Oh, yeah.
And like how we were talking about, like,
they were just open about it. So yeah, what?
I know. Who gives a fuck? Like, who gives a shit?
People get so bent out of shape about gay people being normal. Normal and portrayed in normal society. It's one thing if you try to go out of your way to shove it down somebody's throat. I can see why people get upset about that.
Yeah.
Kinda. I still don't understand some of it. I get more offended, honestly, when somebody tries to shove religion down my throat than if somebody's gay and just out there doing their thing.
Yeah, it's just everything. Like, it's just anything that's... And that's why a lot of people in the Norwegian countries turn to, like, death metal, Gorgoroth, shit like that, burning down churches. It's because they're sick of shit, like religion and stuff, getting shoved down their throat.
So much of it's a control issue.
I know.
But, you know, just the other day, fucking... The Jehovah's Witnesses, apparently the ones I scared off last time, have graduated and moved on or whatever, and there's a new group. Because they knocked on my door the other day, and I didn't hear the door knock because I still have no front porch. So they were at my back door. I didn't hear them. And evidently, they left me one of their little pamphlets and whatnot, so I'm going to have to go scare me some new Jehovah's Witnesses. For those of you who didn't see our episode previously when I discussed this before, we have a group of Jehovah's Witnesses who are around here, and last time they came, I just happened to be playing, like, you know, I think Deicide. I was wearing underwear and a DSI t-shirt, and I answered the door. I'm like, "Hail Satan!" And they kind of said, "Thanks for your time."
I know,
left,
like,
and then never came back.
It's so annoying because they always knock at the most inconvenient time. Like,
well, there's no convenient time to be bothered when I have my own fucking God I pray to.
Yeah, exactly. And it's like your wife finally lets you know try anal on her, and the door knocks, and it's Jehovah's Witnesses, and it's just, it's god awful.
It's part of their fucking religion that they have to go mission like that. But, you know,
but that's the thing. That's what
fuck off.
That's where, you know, when a religion forces you to do something, I would find a new religion. Religion should be about what your personal feelings are with whoever you pray to, not someone telling you what to do or you're going to hell.
Well, almost all religions like that. It's like, hey, I don't like you because you bow down and pray to a different invisible man than I do.
Yeah, exactly. And like George Carlin said it best. He's like, you know, the funny thing about religion is war. War is pretty funny because you have two sides coming at each other and they're both praying to a different god that they'll win. God didn't really pick a country. He didn't really pick a side. Like, you know, they pray better than this country. You know, I'm going to let them win. He's like, someone's going to be disappointed.
Even better when people pray for sporting events.
I know.
That's even stupider.
I know. It's just like, yeah, all these fucking horrible things.
God's got a 20 on the Yankees.
Yeah, exactly. And there was actually a Family Guy episode that made fun of that.
Oh, yeah. I didn't catch that one.
Yeah, the Patriots sucked really bad, and Peter was getting pissed. So he's like, you know what? I'm finding God, and I'm finding out why he's making the Patriots suck, because he kept praying, you know, to make a better. he goes up and God's like, why would I have any hand in that? He's like, I hate sports. He's like, yeah, there's this kid dying in Africa, but I hope the Patriots win. And then they come to find out that God just hates Bill Belichick.
To be fair, everyone hates Bill Belichick.
I know. And they're like, why do you hate him? He's like, you know, I put happiness in the world. The guy never smiles. I don't like it.
The only time I've ever seen him smile, I was afraid his face would crack.
Yeah, I know. But that's the thing.
He smiled after Roger Goodell got booed.
He's like, yeah, motherfuckers. Yeah, he, but actually that was.
That boo was legendary.
Yeah, it was. That was actually part of the thing. God makes a deal with Peter. He's like, if you can get Bill Belichick to smile.
I've never seen that episode.
I'll make the Patriots win. It's fucking hilarious. It's great. I love it. It's great. Everything's a Family Guy quote in my eyes. I love that show.
So did you hear about the Florida dude who got a ticket because he set up a little TV tray in the middle of an intersection, was eating pancakes?
In Florida? No way.
Yeah. That's kind of making its rounds on the internet right now.
Oh my God! Why? What drug was he on? Or was he just born in Florida?
No, he was just doing it for a prank.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say. Actually, I have a friend that posted me something. There is actually a Florida man Twitter. That is updated regularly. There's a Florida woman Twitter, but I guess it hasn't been updated forever. But if you want to ever see anything about Florida, there's a Twitter for it, and it's updated.
That's funny.
Yeah. It's hilarious.
This guy actually got arrested, and he has a court date for April 25th. But yeah, I don't even understand why they arrested him. Just tell him to, like, knock it off. He should have just gotten a warning. He didn't hurt anybody.
They arrest you for everything. Was it Orlando? Do you know?
They arrest you for Lakeland.
Okay. They arrest. Actually, Orlando is one of the few cities they still do jaywalking. They hate it. You jaywalk, they'll taser you.
To be fair, how fucking lazy are you? And I'm gonna cross right here, even though the intersection is 20 feet away.
Well, I can sort of see why they do it. I found a lot out about Florida, and it's very famous, or Orlando, and it's very famous for a lot of things. It's the porn, my mind's going blank, porn convention city of the United States. Never knew that.
Well, yeah, I mean, Disney World's there, so, you know, after you do some fucking, you gotta go ride some rides.
Yeah,
man.
How about it?
Space Mountain after getting your nut off.
Yeah, exactly. How about it? It is also the number one city in America that pedestrians are hit by cars. There is a lot of fucking accidents there. Like, I lived there, I don't even think for a year. And there were so many, just every hour it seemed that someone was getting hit or shot. Yeah, it's crimes really bad in Orlando.
All that guy's a rim shot.
I would come home every night and there would be posters or papers on our door saying, someone in this, you know, place got shot. They had fully automatic weapons. They robbed the place. Please be careful. It's just
like, did you live in like an apartment complex?
Yes.
Or?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And it was actually a rich part of town. It was Winter Park, Florida. And it was outside of Orlando. Very rich. Very rich. But lots of fucking crime. So much crime. Oh, like I said, every day there was just papers on our door saying about how someone got robbed at gunpoint. They just walked into their house, pulled automatic weapons on them, and just robbed them. So me and Jimmy carried guns all over the place. Like, we just, because it was.
Yeah, because anybody should let Jimmy have a firearm. Good Lord.
We had cops even tell us. They're like, we know why you carry. And the one cop was like, I have a son. I bought him a gun as soon as I could because crime's so bad in Orlando. And it's just,
so at least you guys were doing it legally.
Yeah,
at least
exactly.
You were. I don't know about Jimmy.
And that's the thing. Like, gun laws in Florida are very lenient. Like, really lenient.
Well, it is a southern state.
I know, but it's really
not. People don't think of it that way, but it still is.
It's really not until you get more down, like, in the, I don't know. It's a very weird state. I wouldn't say it's a southern state. It's Florida's its own, as you can tell.
Well, the panhandle is very, just very southerny.
Yeah, very.
I have a friend who lives in the panhandle, although I guarantee he doesn't. I'd give him a shout out, but I know he doesn't watch the show because he's studying to be a preacher and he's a very devout Christian. And
you know a friend
we
that's
have
a Christian?
Potty mouth. Yeah.
Wow.
I used to work with him when I wrote for Gadget Spot.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. All right. I was going to say you knew someone that has a comfortable religion. That's weird.
Oh, he's a good kid. His name's Patrick. He's 19.
Patrick sounds like a very clean name.
Yes, my name is Patrick.
Sounds like a very good, clean, like, well, you worship God.
He's very talented with IT and shit, but he's going for the seminary. So
now, is he being a Catholic priest or like?
No, it's
so he can still have sex.
Yeah, well, so do Catholic priests.
Yeah, but just little kids. And that's the thing. Like, I remember when that first got popular and everything. Not popular. I wouldn't say popular. It's cool to molest kids, you know? Hey. Like, when I was really letting out, I was like, I wasn't surprised at all. I was like, so.
Yeah, that's because Father Donovan touched you where you swear it smells funny.
So, like, I was just thinking, I was like, so you're going to take a 20-year-old guy, devote him to Christ, and tell him he can't get married or have sex for the rest of his life.
That's part of the reason why Protestantism became a thing.
Yeah, like, what do you think is going to happen when you get little boys around these guys?
Yeah, Martin Luther and his reasons for creating Protestantism and Lutheranism in the first place is basically saying, like, yeah, you ask people to be celibate, probably not going to happen.
Probably not going to work.
So maybe don't do that.
Yeah, exactly.
And let them get their nut off, and then maybe they'll be okay.
Yeah, it's just fucking weird. I don't know. It doesn't surprise me at all. It doesn't.
Maybe that's why Christian types are all fucking sticks in the mud, because they don't masturbate.
Oh, they do. They do.
Yeah, but they're self-hating masturbators.
Yeah, they fucking, you're dirty. You're dirty. You're not supposed to be
doing
this.
I shouldn't be doing this.
That was actually in Bad Santa last night. This girl of a charity was a fucking whore.
Of course.
And she was just going, like, she was talking about how she used to be an alcoholic. She's like, I used to have 3 ways, 5 ways. And he's just sitting there staring. He's like, 5 ways, bitch, how many holes do you have? It was such a great movie. It was so, and then he meets his mom in it, and she was talking about how she was pregnant with him at 13, and she's like, God, I didn't even know I was pregnant until I tripped over him. It was such a good movie. Oh man, I loved it. It blackened my soul.
That's funny.
Yeah. But anyway,
so you got anything else for us?
No, I think we're good.
All right. Well, I want to give a shout out to something here. I want to start doing some things we love again because we haven't done that in a while. I got a YouTube channel here that my brother-in-law suggested. It's called Bat in the Sun. So if you go on youtube.com/user/batinthesun, it's I can't believe I didn't hear this sooner, but it is some really high quality fan productions. Mm-hmm. And it's almost like if you ever seen the show on Spike TV, The Deadliest Warrior.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of times they take two things, Wonder Woman versus Wolverine or something like that, and they have people vote on it who's going to win, and they reenact a fight scene, and it's fucking great. The acting's great.
They actually interact, do a live scene of it.
Oh, my God, yeah, and it's fantastic. That's pretty fucking... Like, the production qualities are amazing. And my personal favorites are Deadpool and Spider-Man. Do reaction videos.
Oh, my
God. So they do reactions to their own versus things. And they got Deadpool spot on.
Really?
And Spider-Man, too. So if you get a chance, check it out. It's youtube.com/user/batinthesun. Very, very funny.
I'll have to watch that. Actually, that sounds really interesting. I never heard anything like
that. You'll like it. We should probably put a link. In fact, you know what? I'm not even going to say we're going to put a link in the video description because I'm a fucking idiot and we'll forget. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to buffer it and it'll show up on our socials on Thursday.
Got to boof it. I've never heard of something like that. It actually sounds really interesting. I'll have to check that out. Because there is a lot of stuff like that where people, you know, suggest or talk about who would win in this, but that they act it out, I think that's a really nice touch. And I think that works pretty well. Did they just start, do you know? Or?
Yeah, I've been around for a little while. I can't believe I hadn't heard of them. But, I mean, it takes some of these things that you'd love to see, like, you know, DC properties and Marvel properties. Like, for example, they have a Batman versus Deadpool and shit like that. It's great.
Oh, that's awesome.
Absolutely great. So I'm going to go ahead and schedule this for Thursday. So by the time you're listening to this or watching this, it should probably be available.
Huh. I'll have to check that out. Yeah.
Yeah, it's cool. It's very cool.
And it's like I was talking to JD the other day. I finally saw Suicide Squad. It's a weird fucking movie. I don't know.
The movie sucks ass.
Yeah, I don't know how I feel about it yet. It was like...
Fucking crunch berry heads.
Yeah, it had potential, and it started out really well. And then I just don't know where it went wrong. I can't put my finger on it.
Well, the biggest problem with any superhero movie that sucks is they have a shitty villain.
Yeah.
And Suicide Squad has a shitty villain. You've got Enchantress who does stuff because reasons.
Yeah, because she thinks she's a goddess or something, and she feels like people should bow to her or something.
Yeah, it's like...
Yeah, and that's a problem with a lot of movies is the Enchantress and, you know, the Suicide Squad or whatever you call it, really had no beef. There was no beef. It was just like, hey, she's going to destroy the world. Oh, we got to stop her. Like, there was no, the Enchantress, you know, had a, like, history with these people, made them, like, hate her so much to where, you know.
It was, and there was no character development.
Yeah, there's no character, and that's the thing.
Killer Croc is an awesome backstory. All these people have an awesome backstory. Mm-hmm. Captain Boomerang kind of, no, but anyway, like, these people have great backstories, but the only people we get to see anything that is interesting is Harley and Deadshot.
Yeah, that's basically who they focus on, Harley and Deadshot. And that was it.
They do a good thing of making you care about Deadshot by turning him into a doting father. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. And Harley's, you care about because she's hot? I guess
she did have a fucking onion ass in that. So good at make a tear or bring a tear to your eye. It was fucking delicious.
I was gonna go with it's got layers.
Yeah.
Anyway, though.
Jesus Christ.
What's with the fucking tattoos? Why?
And that's another thing. It is the worst portrayal of the Joker I've ever seen in my life.
And it's sad. They squandered Jared Leto because
he's a great actor. He could
have done a great job.
Yeah, he's a great fucking actor.
They fucking ruined it. I
know.
They even ruined, like, the relationship between Harley and the Joker.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the Joker barely acknowledges she's there most of the time in the comics and shit.
Yep.
In fact, for her birthday, he throws her out a fucking window, you know? It's like...
And that's the thing. Like, it was pretty cool. Like, and I took more from, you know, the story between them was pretty much how love can drive you crazy, and it can. And I thought that was pretty cool, but...
Well, it's not even Joker, love. He just manipulated her for fun.
And that's another thing. Like, just what love can do to someone. He treats her like fucking garbage, tries to get her killed all the time, and she's still in love with him.
I believe the love came after the insanity, though.
I know, but I'm just showing how much love and hate and insanity actually is the same thing. Like, hate and love are basically almost the same thing, in my opinion, because...
You really do need a woman.
No, it's just how dangerous they are. Everyone's worried about, oh, there's so much hate in the world. If there's too much love, it turns into hate.
If there's too much love, everybody's smoking weed and fucking... dancing around like hippies.
Yeah, and then some guy steals your weed because he needs a high, and then you beat the fuck and kill each other. Listen to us. We sound like fucking...
I've never known potheads to
ever sound like Jeddas. Hate leads to suffering.
Suffering leads to anger. Anger leads to the dark side. Yeah.
Fuck us. But anyways, that's about it for us. I think it's a good show. Like I said... and like we usually say, buy our stuff.
Please, you know what? Buy lots of shit and become patrons because we want to go to that fucking Blackest of the Black.
Because I want to see what a bunch of underage kids are going to do when they get electrocuted in Bloodbath.
I can't believe it is an all ages thing.
I know. It's so
That's the best part.
Yeah.
So anyway, follow us on Twitter. Follow us on Google+. Follow us on Facebook, Patreon. Patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. You can buy our shit on spreadshirt.com/openlyhostileopinions or just go to openlyhostileopinions.com. That is a mouthful. We will see y'all next week. Thanks a lot. See you later.
Hey, have a good one.
Fucking if you're going to like blow loads all over the place, make sure you have a vasectomy like I do.
Peace, bitches.
Catch y'all later.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.